Greetings everyone, Melkadrian here, and I'm here to show you Crypt of the NecroDancer, currently out on Steam Early Access, and by Jove, this is a very fun game, mainly because it adds both aspects of a rhythm-based game and a roguelike game into what I'm going to be calling a, well, rhythm roguelike. Anyways, here we are in the lobby where we can basically do a few things, train against enemies, train against bosses, buy items that appear in chests or in shops in the dungeon below or zones, or permanent upgrades which just appear right off the bat. You don't have to find them in the dungeon at all. However, in order to buy these upgrades, you need diamonds, which you have to find, well, in the dungeon below. And each zone here, that's the dungeons, they get difficult the further down you get. Zone 1 is pretty easy, Zone 2 is somewhat there, Zone 3 gets more difficult. I've not gotten to Zone 4 yet, so let's just say it gets a little more difficult the further down you get, because, well, enemies get tougher, and well, you have to work yourself around the rhythm so you don't end up dying or getting pinned down. Let's get into the game proper. Here we can dig around and find treasure chests. These treasure chests have, well, random items in them. They could have, you know, weapons. Well, actually, these chests, depending on the color or if they're mimics, they will drop various things. This, well, basically drop either food or torches, which is useful because torches light up the area so you can find out where you need to go and, well, show you the hidden areas. Shopkeepers, they have various items for a price, and the shopkeeper does sing. Listen to him. Yes, he really can sing well, and that's, I really like this shopkeeper because of that. The shop sells three items. They're completely random, so, well, yeah, they're just completely random, so you will see the inventory change every time you see the shop. Now, if you move, now, as I said, if you don't move along to the beat, you will kind of get left behind. And if you goof up, like I'm doing right now, basically, you miss out on the move. And everything else moves around of you. Once you figure out the beats in the level, things become a little bit easier, sort of. Oh, dragon. Now, some monsters have a lot of health, and only that, but some enemies are guardian monsters, which protect the stairs. You don't exactly need to take the stairs to go to the next floor, but it is highly recommended for beginners, because if you fall down a trapdoor, chances are you will find a room full of enemies you do not want to fight. Gotta get to the exit, because, hold on. See, the bars are now red instead of blue. That means the song is reaching its end. If it reaches the end and you haven't reached a stairs in time, you will basically lose your combo and fall to the next floor through a trapdoor that will appear from under you. A holster, that's not exactly what I really care about. What I really care about is a very good weapon, because we start off with the most basic of essentials, a dagger and a shovel. Not exactly good stuff. We also start off with a bomb as well, which can be used for various things, which is a good thing. Scrolls have the Well, scrolls. Hold on, I'm just trying to concentrate while moving along to the game. It's kind of hard to focus on the game and talk at the same time. The effects of the scrolls, they're the same at... they're always the same. Well, depending on the color. Now, as you can see, I died, so I have to... I get to see my summary and my instant replay of my death, or my victory, depending on what happens. You can watch my replay, or I can restart or return to my lobby. Let's do a quick restart. See if I can complete the zone without having to mess up. Come on! Yeah, it's Zooks! I am certainly not moving to the rhythm today. Large monsters like those, they're unaffected by the floor panels on the ground, like trapdoors or pits or spikes. Anything like that that are on the floor, they're largely unaffected by them. Smaller enemies, most of them they're affected by, others are not. That's a shrine right there, and various shrines have various effects. Some are give you boons, some give you some powerful items at a price. I'm moving too fast again. There's the shopkeeper over there. Now these walls here, a bit of a interesting thing. They're made of gold. They're completely made of gold. So if you need gold and you don't want to kill any monsters, you can just bomb them. Get some free gold for it. At the price of a bomb, anyways. Ah, more bombs. Let's see, any hidden items? Nope. Ah! Let's see if I can find... I think the shopkeeper's up there by the green dots. I want to see what he has because, well... as I said before, he has various items. They randomize every... well, every time you go into a floor. It could be good stuff, it could be just junk. It might be something that you might be able to use, or sometimes it may be blocked off by a gold brick. That's a glass broadsword. That's a very powerful weapon. However, there is a drawback to it considering the fact that if you take a hit, it will break. And if it breaks and you have no other weapon, you're kind of up the river. However, it does drop a glass shard, so you can pick it up. I wish that if it breaks, you would just have the glass shard afterwards. Like, it breaks, and then you just have the glass shard right then and there. It just... the weapon instantly turns into a glass shard. Which is basically comparable to your beginner's dagger. Not very powerful, but... it has its uses. I just think that is one thing that could be done about it. I feel like that, if the weapon breaks, you would at least have a shard of it in your hand. Instead of just, dropping the weapon and then having to pick up the glass shard. Ah! Come on, Self, we can do this. Do you have anything in here? There are hidden chests inside those rooms sometimes. Let's see. I'll take a Kuretigi and the Red Skrull. And I messed up again. Oh boy. I'm really not doing so good. All right, one more time. Let's see if I can get it done in this round alone. Once you start off playing this game, you will basically be learning on how to move to the beat and being able to working on not dying. That's a good weapon there, Titanium Broadsword. You can usually figure out what type of weapon it is by the color of it. Some basically give you the effects of healing after a number of hits. Some are extremely powerful, but if you take a hit, it breaks. And some have other effects, such as a whip. Like it has more range horizontally. Well, what's the word I'm looking for? In the department that is opposite to you, you know, if your face, you're moving downward, it'll check every tangent. It'll check the line perpendicular to your field of vision. Like if you're moving horizontally, it'll check vertically. And some extend your combat distance, like this rapier. Very effective, but I prefer the broadsword because it gives me the firepower right off the bat. I don't need to be at a distance for it. That's the perk about this rapier. If you're at a distance, you'll be able to deal extra damage. Don't have money, but I can borrow one of these and get some gold. Ah, heal spell. Come on, can I make it to the exit? There we go. And now I have a good weapon. There is also armor in this game, which is a benefit because, well, a lot of things have benefits. Armor allows you to has various effects. That Kuretigi that you basically saw me wear in the last run, it basically allowed me, well, increased my firepower. Some armor gives you damage resistance, while others basically power you up. Ring of Charisma, Titanium Spear. That's a shrine I'm not gonna touch because, well, it's a risky. If I remember right, that's a shrine of risk. And we don't want to deal with that. I screwed up there. Now, if you make an action that is incorrect or wrong, like something that isn't coded in, it's comparable to missing. It's comparable to missing that beat. Gold spear, don't want that. What do you have here? Cheese. That's good. Because it's food. Food is good. That's a thing I never knew about these boots. And now you guys know too. Which is being able to walk in water without having to, well, jump to get out. Can't break through, huh? Oh, great, it's the conga line. That could have gone better. Anyways, that went well. And that's my coin score, which basically is your score for that run. Wow. I really need to get some practice in for those zones until I, well, at least not right now. I still have to open up the rest of the zones and deal with Zone 3, which is far more difficult than Zone 1. So until next time, this is Melkadrian, and this is a look at Crypt of the Necrodancer. Remember, it's out on Steam Early Access, and it's a very fun game. You guys will likely like it as much as I did, which is a lot. Until then, I'm signing off.